Yeah. Hallelujah. Welcome to today's service. Welcome the person next to you. As we are reading Psalm 109, welcome them to the service. Help me, O Lord, my God. Written to the choir master, that he is a son of David. Be not silent, O God, of my praise, for wicked and deceitful mouths have opened against me, speaking against me with lying tongues. They encircle me with words of hate and attack me without cause. In return of my love, they accuse me, but I give myself to prayer. So they reward me evil for good and hatred for my love. Appoint a wicked man against him. Let an accuser stand at his right hand. When he is tried, let him come forth guilty. Let his prayer be counted as sin. May his days be few. May another take his office. May his children be fatherless, and his wife a widow. May his children wander about and beg, seeking food far from the ruins they inhabit. May the creditor seize all that he has. May strangers plunder the fruits of his toil. Let there be no one to extend kindness to him, nor any to pity his fatherless children. May his posterity be cut off. May his name be blotted out in the second generation. May the iniquity of his fathers be remembered before the Lord. And let not the sin of his mother be blotted out. Let them be before the Lord continually, that he may cut off the memory of them from the earth. For he did not remember to show kindness, but pursued the poor and needy, and the brokenhearted, to put them to death. He loved to curse. Let curses come upon him. He did not delight in blessing. May it be far from him. He clothed himself with cursing as his coat. May it soak into the body like water, like oil into his bones. May it be like a garment that he wraps around him, like a belt that he puts on every day. May this be the reward of my accusers from the Lord, of those who speak evil against my life. But you, O God, my Lord, deal on my behalf for your name's sake, because your steadfast love is good, deliver me. For I am poor and needy, and my heart is stricken within me. I am gone like a shadow at evening. I am shaken off like a locust. My knees are weak through fasting. My body has become gaunt with no fat. I am an object of scorn to my accusers. When they see me, they wag their heads. Help me, O Lord my God. Save me according to your steadfast love. Let them know that this is your hand. You, O Lord, have done it. Let them curse, but you will bless. They arise and are put to shame, but your servant will be glad. May my accusers be clothed with dishonor. May they be wrapped in their own shame, as in a cloak. With my mouth I will give great thanks to the Lord. I will praise him in the midst of the throng, for he stands at the right hand of the needy one, to save him from those who condemn his soul to death. My brothers and sisters, this is an individual lament. A faithful Israelite is being attacked in return for the good he has done to his attackers. And that's what we see in verses 1 to 5. He prays that his accusers would receive what they deserve. All through verses 6 to 20.
and the some clauses with our prayer that appeals to God's steadfast love. Verses 21 to 31. The tone and content of this psalm will cause Psalm 69. A major difference is that the sufferer in Psalm 69 acknowledges that wrongs he has done have played a role in his troubles, while the sufferer in this psalm, Psalm 109, professes innocence. That's the big difference between verse 109 and verse 69. And so in both psalms, the enemies are influential Israelites who are unfaithful to the covenant between God and the Israelites. This is one of a very good and great psalm. And many people, just like the psalmist here, have gone through the very same fate. For the openings describes the situation. People attack the singer without cause. The psalm offers the right response when he says that I give myself to prayer. This includes prayers for his enemies in the past, like the prayers he has done in Psalm 35, especially verse 13. The psalm opens that Pigana na wale wanao pigana na mimi, fight with those who are fighting me. And so prayers for God's help in the present are highly needed. He says in verse 1, be not silent. That is, do not let people think that you are accepting of evil. So do not let people think that you are accepting of evil. Also Psalm 28 verse 1, a replica to it. And what I've seen between verses 6 to 20, he talks of very heavy words. And he even includes the parents to those people. So the psalmist asks God to defend him by bringing on his enemies the troubles they deserve. The wicked man and accuser. And remember, whoever digs a pit falls into the same pit. And this psalm is not bad, because Deuteronomy 28 verse 7, he says they will come in one way, but he will disperse them into seven. And so, all that, we also see that when the Israelites are talked and spoken of, we turn to Genesis 12. Verse 3, he tells Abraham that whoever curses you will be cursed, and whoever blesses you will be blessed. And so he is unordered on point when he is praying all this. For the wicked man and accuser have opened wicked mouths against the psalmist, and they accuse him, that is the psalmist, of very many things. And so the psalmist is asking that they suffer the same fate with what they wanted him to suffer. That's why I've given you the example of Psalm 69. The difference is in Psalm 69, he is not innocent, but in Psalm 109, he is innocent. So one must recall that the people being cursed are grievous sinners. They are covenant members who are unfaithful to the covenant. They will use whatever means they can to oppress the faithful. It can also be assumed that they've refused to repent. He says in verse 8 that may another take his office. This is his office of oversight. And there are very many verses talking of that. An example is Numbers 3, verse 32, 1 Chronicles 26, 30, Ezekiel 44, verse 1. And our responsible position among the people of God, meaning that these people knew God and it's like they are part of the ministers. And again, he talks of their children in verse 9 to 12, their wives, their mothers. So the man's early death would leave his family in poverty. Contrast of Psalm 37, verse 25. See in Exodus 34, verse 7. Visiting the iniquity of the fathers on the children, he talks of I will repay this from first to the fourth generation. A person's sin makes others suffer, especially those closest to him. And so that is why you must always remain faithful to the Lord. He says in verse 16 that you not remember to show kindness. This is the explanation for the punishment prayed for in verse 12. The surest evidence of a person's faith in God is his kindness to those who are most vulnerable, the poor and needy, and the brokenhearted. And so the cursed person seeks to harm and take advantage of them instead. Lastly, verses 21 to 29, the psalmist asks for God's protection from their attacks. He also asks that the accusers be disgraced in verse 29. That is, be unable to continue intimidating and harming. So the singer appeals to God's steadfast love in verses 21 and verse 26, and to his own powerlessness in verses 22 to 25. I know many people have the same challenges and the same means of survival, but today God is speaking to us in the surest way of protection and is surely faithful. Kindly continue welcoming the person next to you as you open your mouth in your own words to speak a word.
Spirit, the seed is right. Se mama, mama. Yeah. Oh, Oh, Mama, Bwana Yesu, Oh, Thank you. Thank you. there's none like you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you. Inua sauti yako kwa Mungu. Nashanga wengine wameketi wanaangalia tu. Huu ni wakati mzuri, wakati wako na Mungu. Wakati ambao tumepewa, wakati wa kiajabu, wakati ambao Mungu amekujalia. Naomba kwa jina la Yesu Kristo, ikiwa uko na nguvu ukasimame, ukamuinulie Mungu sauti yako, ukampe sifa na utukufu katika jina la Yesu. Pasa sauti yako kwa Mungu, pasa sauti yako. Leo ni leo, leo ni siku ya ajabu ambayo Mungu ametujalia, ambayo Yesu ametupea katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Inua Mungu kwa sauti yako. Vijana uko nyuma, katika jina la Asante mtakatifu. Pigia Yesu makofi ya shangwe na vigelegele kwa Bwana Yesu. Pigia Yesu makofi. Pesifa heshima na utukufu. Pigia kelele takatifu kwa Yesu. Pigia Yesu kelele takatifu. Thank you Jesus. Tumia sana na stahili. Asante Baba yetu. Asante Mungu mkuu. Hakuna aliye kama wewe. Unastahili Jehova.
Lord, we bless your name. Thank you, Jesus. May you be praised and adored forever.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.